Hello to all our followers and welcome to this new episode of 5 Minutes. Today we will talk about cosmopolitan democracy versus populism, a key challenge left to the millennial, with our guest, Professor Daniele Archibugi, Research Director of the Council National Research of Italy and Professor at Birkbeck University of London. Daniele, welcome to 5 Minutes. We are very delighted to
Hello,
have
Luca.
You here with
lovely,
us.
Hello, Luca. Lovely to be here.
Thank you so much. So let me start with the first question. Daniele, you have talked many times about cosmopolitan democracy. What do we mean with this term?
We are lucky because we are in a period in which a democratic government has expanded across nations, and the number of democratic countries have doubled. Some of them are at risk, Russia, Turkey, and so on. But if we look at the historical period, indeed, we see that quite a lot of countries, think about Latin America, think about Eastern Europe, now part of the European Union, are moved to democratic rule. Is that enough? And actually, the colleagues which advocate a cosmopolitan democracy argue that this is not enough, and we need also to build democratic relationships across nations. Some of our colleagues call it global democracy. Nothing against that. I think that cosmopolitan democracy is more precise because it's not just an issue across nations, but sometimes even across smaller communities. Think about a lake which is in between two countries, or any other situation in which there are smaller groups of stakeholders which might use democratic devices in order to get better governance.
Thank you so much. So let's move towards what I think it is the opposite of cosmopolitan democracy, at least from my understanding, which is populisms. Why do you think we have been recently experiencing the rise or waves of populisms, particularly within well-established Western democracies?
I think the reason is very simple. Because over the last 30, 40 years, income inequality has increased, including in democratic countries. And actually, if we look at what has been the effect of democracy over income distribution, we find out that in some cases, democracy has meant a more equal income distribution, such as in Latin American countries. In other countries we moved toward democracy, such as Eastern European countries, the opposite has happened. And that's because democracy is often linked to capitalism. And capitalism is not a system which leads to social justice. And therefore, there is the wrong reaction. And the wrong reaction is to think that by going back to nationalistic forces, it will be possible to revert the situation. We think the opposite. We think that the globalization needs to be put under control of democratic forces. And therefore, we believe that if the people of different countries, which will be able to have a forum where they can deliberate and also decide about common policies, it's more likely that the poor people will get more and the rich people will get less.
So do you think that cosmopolitan democracy can be a solution to populism?
I think so. I think so because populism is is a reaction to some real problems. But once we recognize that the real problems are there, it's not enough to go back to national issues. And actually, we see everywhere in the world that the populism has not been able to provide one single substantial solution. It's just very good to signal the problems, while I hope that if there is a better global governance through the participation of people, we can really get a better solution to our problem. Think about the environment. Do we really think that populism is an answer to pollution, for example, or many other global issues? Do we really think that by stopping international trade, some countries will be, at the end of the day, better off? And that's the reason why we need globalization, but under new forms of democratic control.
Thank you. So, in your opinion, how far are we nowadays from cosmopolitan democracy, and what should be done to get closer?
It's not a good moment for cosmopolitan democracy. Is that quite clear? It's not a good moment because Brexit is a bad sign, because the election of Trump within the United States is a bad sign, because several leaders in countries such as Russia, Turkey, and others have got a lot of popular support despite the fact that they violate human rights. But we need to get ready. Because at the end, I think that all this situation will pass, and we need to have a political project in order to understand what's next. And actually, the COVID-19 crisis shows very much that we need more global governance. And this global governance cannot be provided just by a few governments or by a few experts. We need a greater involvement on the population at large.
Thank you so much, Daniele, for this inspiring discussion. We wish you
all
the best,
much,
and we really hope to see you here again at 5 minutes. Thank you very much.
Bye. Ciao, ciao.
Bye. Thank you.